Welcome to e-Pathashala. Now we are going to talk about public spaces like Gandhi Mandapam, which is in the heart of the city, next to the Raj Bhavan. It's in Chennai city, where you know suddenly we ourselves do not know that area comprises of 17 acres of land. Such a huge land available in the heart of the city and used for nothing. So we were given an opportunity to design that land suitable for the public. So what we have done basically in that area is to provide a larger open space for the public in that near vicinity area. Plus people who are visiting Gandhi Mandapam will have enjoying a very good garden and a very good walkway available for them. Then they also try to create a larger pond in the back area where the low lying area is happening, so that rainwater can be harvested and used for better improvement of the garden. That was the basic intention. We also shifted the parking to one corner so that all vehicle parking can happen at the west side of the Gandhi Mandapam area. Actually, Gandhi Mandapam comprises of Gandhi Mandapam, then you have Rajaji Mandapam, Kamarajar Mandapam. All the three put together, plus lot of other dignitaries are also there as in the form of statues. So we have to cater to all the needs, and we also have the check, we call it a tunnel, whereas the oil was extracted through rotating the barren, we call it the check with the thermal. So we had Vavu Chidambaramnar was there. He has pulled out that one, and that one has been kept as a model here. So he did produce oil through that particular equipment. So that was a historical event for our freedom fighting. So and all the people who are all there are very highly freedom fighters are only in that area. So people, students, kids who will come there will have a knowledge about these important events happened in the history of Indian freedom. Then we also have the Gandhi Mandapam where a lot of prayer, bhajans will take place. Then you have Kamarajar and Rajaji Mandapam where people can see their statues, and then their memorials are there. Then you have a lot of other peoples are also there. So this being one of the largest open space with 17 acres of land, we have provided all the facilities. Even battery car can be operated all along the walkway for the people to go, and lot of seating arrangement have been created. Different varieties of plants, materials are used, so you can go and enjoy.
Good day to all. Today we are going to talk about memorial landscaping. What is the importance of a memorial? Memorial is a place where we try to remember our leaders who have sacrificed their life for our freedom and who earned their name as a leader in our category. So what are we, how are you going to do the landscaping? The leaders normally have an open-minded, I mean, there everybody can read their lifestyle, read their actions and everything. So your landscaping also has to be contributing to their character, their achievements, etc. Everything need to be taken care. Now we are going to talk about Gandhi Mandapam in Chennai, which covers roughly an area of 17 acres. Believe it or not, it's such a huge place with institutional building all around and a lot of visitors coming to this particular place. So you have a 17 acres of park for the people. So how do you design it? How do you use it for the memorial purpose? Plus you have to double it, double usage as a park for the people, because there is no other open space available for the people in this region. So this comprises almost 17 acres, not a small area, quite a big area. and moreover this is open to the main traffic on the Raj Bhavan Road. You can call it, that's a Gandhi Mandapam Road. You have that major road is there. Everybody can see the project. Everybody can see the landscaping. So how are you going to attack the whole thing? That's the whole thing we are going to talk about it today. Location, it's called a Sardar Patel Road in Adyar. So the memorial concept, they have people of eminence such as Rattamalai Srinivasan, Rajaji, Kamarajar and Bhaktavachalam. Then you have a Gandhi Mandapam. And this area is dedicated to all the leaders of this region. It is, the architecture is built up in a temple style. Open space is available as a recreational park for the city. Recreation means not that you have a children's play area. This mandapam is built on a temple architectural style. This was acting as a one of the meditation centers during Gandhi's birth and death anniversary. Other than that, not much of activity taking place other than some kind of a bhajans in the evening. Other thing. Now, once you double it up as a park for the people and a large open space with a good parking facility, this can act as a breakaway space for the people of this area. Apart from that, we have a cancer institute next to the Gandhi Mandapam where you have lot of patients are coming. This will act as one of the very good walking space for the patients, and you have all the other facilities that there is such a huge greenery available, lot of oxygen for the people. So you have to think in terms of other usage other than the memorial usage. Whereas you see Rajghat or Sakti Sthal in Delhi where you know it is purely memorial oriented. This would, okay, people come just to see it also as a tourist spot. But here it's more of a recreation, passive recreation place for the people. So memorial statues are there. We have to create a park with walkway, seating, water feature, plus greenery. Memorial should convey the meaning of peace, tranquility, walkway, silence, memory of the person for whom you are designing it. It is more important when you are designing for a memorial. Study design criteria of a memorial. As I discuss a statue of the person, commemorative spaces, it need to be. Lot of people will be gathering during death and birth anniversary, so you need a people, sculptures, fountain, parks, tree courts, shaded area, public toilet, parking. All the facilities are needed in order to make this as a function as a park for the people. So we have 5 zones here. One is a parking area. We have pushed the parking onto the other side of the Raj Bhavan area, wherein all the cars and everything can be parked, and then people can walk or they can use a battery operated car so that people can see the entire area and come back. Then second one is the memorial area, third one is greenery area, fourth one is a water feature, and then entry and exit points. Basically it's only one entry and other. Gandhi Mandapam has got some entry point. We don't want to retain it or anything like that, but we are just retaining it, but it will be closed door because people will be entering from only one side of the area, which is on the western side of the park. Secluded parking on the corner of the side so that no accident can happen. Gandhi statue is the main focus of this project. This statue is located on the center of the site where its focus is created by a series of avenue trees and linear pathway leading to the statue. The other two smaller memorials, Rajaji and Kamarajar, are located on either side of the Gandhi statue. The entire site is spread out with a lush green water feature and also functions as a park. This is the basic idea of this particular Gandhi Mandapam area. Again, we have divided into zoning of 5 zones: parking, memorial, greenery, water feature, entry points. Vegetation. The site contains ample vegetation native to this region, contributing its part to microclimate of the area, along with IIT campus, Guindy National Park, Anna University, and Raj Bhavan. All these become a green belt of Chennai. hedge planted on the site has made this space cramped. Also, unpruned trees, the memorial structures have no focus or directed towards the structure. The compound wall is also need to be opened up so that people from outside can see inside. And we had a 5 different types of design on the compound wall, so we have to make it a uniform compound wall. Parking need to be, different parking was there for a different memorial, so need to be organized as a single parking. Then design involved 3 prime zones. One is the open zone focusing on the material. 2 is a recreational zone. 3rd one is a serene zone as a memorial on the backdrop. These are the 3 different activity we like to give it. Recreation means it's more of a passive recreation than anything else. People can sit and chat or do anything like that. The open zone where one enters into the memorial complex, therefore the open space is landscaped by undulating mounds and the foreground is memorial, so you can have a large expanse of lawn available so that you feel the vastness of the space. Because of this undulating, you also connect to the places, number one. Number two, the space of for contemplation where one can sit, feel the serenity on the setting. These mounds also hide the kind of traffic from inside to outside. This is the kind of a view what we envisaged initially. When it comes to planting design, I will let you know what kind of plants we have chosen to achieve this kind of a gradation, number one. Number two, the different planting pattern. The recreational zone again, you know, comprises of small play pen for the kids, because any park, you know, kids are more attractive. Tree grows and gazebos and lawn areas. Extension of vegetation, especially a wide number of banyan trees are available and will become a part of this proposed space. And you can also create some kind of a thatched gazebos for, will act as a rain shelter also. So serene zone where we have a large water body, all the rainwater will be collected here. And we have water lilies and other things grown up in this area. Will also reduce the microclimate or improve the microclimate of this area. Also attracts birds. There is a kind of a small canal river concept is brought in by large parts of the canal, creating water storage area in the form of lily ponds with bunds to retain water levels. I think you can also read all these things whatever we have written in this. This is a kind of paving, kind of gazebo seating, kind of pergolas, kind of planting we have to take place in this zone. Planting is taken as a major concept. Undulating mounds are provided in varying heights and shapes in this huge expansive area. Lush green with clumps of shrubs and ground cover interspaced. The mounds also, you know, may not become a monotonous, so that you have lot of plants interspaced. Rich, colorful and contrasting foliage between mounds where the depression or valley is formed. Water absorbing and plants that grow in swampy areas are proposed near the water bodies so that we would also take care of the natural ecology of this area. So you have different kind of planting in the car parking area. You have trees for the car sheds, you have low level planting for the curb walls, so that this area is totally segregated. Yeah, this is the kind of planting plan you are having. You can read everything, what plants we have used and all. And we can also take out from what is the purpose of these plants. Kentia plants are planted in the median with spider lily on the bottom, so that your bottom layer is also covered. The vertical level, for vertical level you have Kentia plants. Phoenix palms are planted in clusters. All these things will give a vertical garden effect, and you have a connecting pathways. Again, you have trees and then hedges planted. Existing trees are also identified and proper ground cover has been planted on that. Colorful planting in between the mounds and valley points. You can see that colorful plants are used, like bougainvilleas, axoras. Then you have cypress planting for the water body all along the river, kind of thing what we have created. Nerium oleander, which is a native plant and it's give a very good smell also. So those kind of plants are used here. The open, large open space, undulating mound interspaced with the shade grass, shaded trees and palms. The valley between the mounds are planted with colorful plantage. Huge undulating mounds are provided in the forefront and smaller mounds in the rear area. So it really creates meadows and then lawn area, so that the large open space is connected to other places. And your planting has to be corrected or planted in such a way your access to the memorial need to be ceremonial. So how are you going to do that ceremonial pathway, which is more important? And the entry of the Gandhi Madhavam is very straight and clean. Linear water body is proposed in the front of the memorial, which leads straight to the memorial. Lush green planting with raffles and arika palms with mild undulating mounds in front of the memorial. No trees or hedges are planted along the sides, so that you see the openness of the memorial. How are you planting in between the mounds? This is what the plan shows. Different type of plants are planted in the mound area. This is a view of the mount area with different planting. Boundary planting. Water body in the backyard. Rain harvesting pond. Different planting, Cicilpenia pulcherrima, very colorful plant. Ficus Krishna, one of the very good trees there. Neem trees. Gandhi Memorial area and their planting plan. Because Gandhi Mandapam, you need a serene atmosphere, so we cannot use a vibrant colors are not used here. Only shades of greenery on either side of the memorial are proposed, so that you don't have a colorful or very vibrant colors in this area, so that serene atmosphere is retained. You have raffles, you have arika palm, you have Alistronia scholaris. Things like that are only used here. This is Rajaji Memorial area planting plan. Different shade loving plants. Different planting ideas. Tree coat with Alistronia scholaris and with the ground cover Cleodendron Thompsonae or a climber in that area. Three kinds of trees are used in the memorial: flowering trees, scented flower trees, and shade trees. Scented flowering trees. Millingtonia hortensis. We call it jasmine tree. So very scented tree to be used in that. Only problem with this tree is the roots can grow. One more tree, this will become forest by itself. So whenever we do plant this tree, you have to make a planter or you have to make a wall around the tree so that the roots doesn't grow beyond the walled area, so that it will not become a forest of its own. You can read this. Mimosaphis elangi, very highly scented, slow growing tree, but a very effective tree. You can read them. Flowering trees. Spathodia, very good growing, nicely grown in Chennai climate. A red color, orange color flowers. Can see the close view of the flowers. Cassia spectabilis, very fantastic tree, grows up to 60 feet height, does very well in our climate. Canophyllum inophyllum. In Tamil, we call it Punnai Maram. It's a local tree, very well grown, fragrant with white flower. Talking about Canophyllum inophyllum, it's a Punnai Maram in Tamil. It's a very good evergreen tree, fragrant white flowers. The details about the trees are given below. You can add the slide more time, I'll keep moving. Corpotova guyanensis, it's called as Nagalinga Maram in Chennai, in Tamil. It was a very good flowering thing. The flower also helps lot of aromatic therapy, it has got it. One of the very good scented flowers. People always have a myth about this particular tree, stating that snakes will be there. It's not like that. Just because the flowering pattern is in such a way that it looks as if snakes are there. It's a very good tree to be having in every house. Supposed to produce a lot of oxygen, improve the health of the person. This tree has got a lot of medicinal value plus aromatic value. These flowers are used in the temple for Shiva, for puja purpose. But a slow growing tree. Your flowering will start only after 5 years. Then we come to the other next tree, is called a Plumeria alba. Again, this is called as a temple tree, a local name. Lot of colors are available, hybrid varieties are available, lot of varieties are available in this. This is a white color we are talking. The next one is Cassia germanica. Very good flowers. Pink flowers. We are going to next classification of shaded trees. Alistonia scholaris. Large square shaped tree, actually this one is. leaves are so dense, it's very shaded tree, it's called very good shade it gives you. Because of the denseness, you even sunlight won't come down. Then you have our neem tree. Excellent medicinal value tree. Tall shrubs. Call it Munda grass. Botanical name is Pinicium rubrum. Pinicetum rubrum. Okay, Pinicetum rubrum. These plants are used to give color and to fill up the areas normally. Nerium oleander. Call it Arali in Tamil. Very good scented flowers, beautiful flowering. There are white, pink and yellow colors are available. Bougainvillea, fantastic plant. You want it to flower, stop watering. Two watering alternate, reduce the water, then it will start blooming like anything. Very hardy plant. There are 2500 varieties of bougainvilleas are available. Normally now we have something around 45-50 in the market. Extensive coloring. Canna. Very hot plant, you know, for this particular plant you need lot of sunlight, number one. Number two, you have to use a manure like horse manure, you know. You need lot of heat for the roots in order to flower. Once upon a time this was used extensively all over the landscaping. Now it is not much used, but it's a very good plant. Once the flowering is over, you know, it looks very dry and other thing. New shoots will come, start flowering, takes a time. Color, very colorful flowers. Tichoma capensis, very good for a coastal area. It takes care of your salt spray and other thing. Good hedge plant, good flowering. Cypress alternifolia, water plant. Near the water body you can plant this one. It's called as umbrella plant also. Eranthemum. Lot of varieties of eranthemum are there. Mainly this can be used for foliage color. Yellow color flowers, foliage is available. Flowering is not that much, but still it does flowers. More used for foliage color. Calandra grandiflora, we call it powder puff. Calandra is a powder puff, we call it. Red color flowers are there. Normally it is maintained at 6 to 8 feet height. Flowers are so beautiful. Cicilpenia pulcherrima, you get different colors, but until unless it grows up and gives a flower, you won't know which color you are going to get. But it's a rash of colors you get. Acalypha, again a foliage color plant. 3 or 4, 5, 6 varieties are available. Euphorbia, again a thorny plant, can be used in an area where you don't want human interference, but a very good flower, red color flower it gives you. Graptophyllum pitchum, again a foliage plant. Spider lily, you want to see it bloom, you need a rain. When the rain tomorrow itself, it will start blooming. Lot of varieties are there in spider lily. Adenium, a sculpture plant. You get very plenty of flowers. It looks almost like a bonsai tree, but a very good ascent plant. Bird of paradise, a little bit of rare plant, but it's a good one. Philodendron gold, again a shade loving plant. Aglaonema, again a shade loving plant, foliage plant. Little bit of costly varieties. Schefflera, mainly these plants have come in recent times, where you know it's all used to mainly for a shaded area plus semi shaded area, not shaded area exactly. You can use it for color. Alpine, again you know this is a very good plant for good sunlight also. It does very well with a good sunlight. Ground covers, Zabrina pendula. Bedelias, very good. Large area you can cover it up with this. Rio, discolor, Rio, other names are there.
We have been seeing the entire Gandhi Mandapam presentation and we talk more about the conclusion. Being this as the largest open space in this vicinity, people have to really come and enjoy the greenery, and this also will improve the microclimate of the area with a good lawn and rain harvesting pond and walking areas for the people. And this is also next to the Cancer Institute, where a lot of people with the cancer problem comes there, and we also have a lot of walking space provided in this particular park. People can use this area effectively for their morning walk, and then patients and patients' relative coming there can use this open space very effectively and enjoy the place. Thank you.